Good morning. Welcome to Blessed Sacrament Church and welcome to our liturgy. Happy Thanksgiving, everyone. Our presider for this afternoon is Father Ike, and I hope that you keep warm during this holiday season.
Buenos días a todos. Feliz día de Acción de Gracias. Les damos la bienvenida en esta hermosa mañana y a quienes están en sus casas o donde quiera que se encuentren. Hasta ahí enviamos esta señal por Facebook. Un cordial saludo a todas las personas que nos están sintonizando y viendo esta transmisión de esta Santa Misa fuera de nuestras fronteras hasta Austria. Mandamos un cordial saludo a la familia García, Valeria García, que está pendiente de su parroquia y que le extraña mucho, y a todos ustedes en casa, un abrazo fraternal en este día de Acción de Gracias. Siempre es bueno dar gracias en todo momento a Dios en nuestra vocación de cristianos. Nuestro sacerdote el día de hoy es Padre Ike. Nos ponemos de pie y demos un saludo de señal a todos los presentes y a ustedes ahí en casa, un abrazo fraternal donde quiera que se encuentren. Iniciemos pues.
Nos convertimos en cuerpo del Señor.
The Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We are many made one around the table of the Lord. Hence today we will have a little bit of a multilingual worship. And so the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, el amor del Padre, atangliwanang ng Espiritu Santo ay sumainyong lahat. Be with you all. Amen. Vamos a tratar. Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving, you too.
Feliz Día de Acción de Gracias.
Feliz Día de Acción de Gracias para usted.
Maligayang araw ng pasasalamat.
Maligayang araw ng pasasalamat.
Dice, Bien, bienvenidos a todos. Welcome. To prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us acknowledge our total dependence on God. Porque sin la providencia divina, no podemos hacer nada.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Cristo, ma agua acá. Cristo, ma agua acá. Señor, ten piedad.
Señor, ten piedad.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Amen.
Gloria al Señor que reina en el cielo y en la tierra paz a los hombres que ama Él. Gloria al Señor que reina en el cielo y en la tierra paz a los hombres que ama Él. Señor, te alabamos, Señor, te bendecimos, todos te adoramos, gracias por tu gloria. Gloria al Señor que reina en el cielo y en la tierra paz a los hombres que ama Él. Tú eres el Cordero que quitas el pecado. Ten piedad de nosotros y escucha nuestra oración. Gloria al Señor que reina en el cielo y en la tierra paz a los hombres que ama Él. Tú solo eres santo, tú solo el Altísimo, con el Espíritu Santo, en la gloria de Dios Padre. Gloria al Señor, que reina en el cielo, y en la tierra paz a los hombres que ama Él. Y en la tierra paz a los hombres.
Amén. Oremos. Dios Todopoderoso, cuyos dones de amor son incontables y cuya bondad es infinita. We come before you on this Thanksgiving Day to thank you for all your goodness and to ask that you open our hearts so that we can serve our neighbors. Haz que seamos capaces de compartir generosamente los dones que de ti hemos recibido. Por nuestro Señor Jesucristo, tu Hijo, que vive y reina contigo en la unidad del Espíritu Santo y es Dios por los siglos de los siglos. Amén. Podemos sentar. Escuchamos de la palabra. Multilingüe.
Pagbasa mula sa aklat ni Sirak. At ngayon, purihin natin ang Panginoon, ang Diyos ng Israel. Kahanga-hanga ang kanyang mga gawa sa balat ng lupa. Siya ang nagtataguyod sa atin mula pa sa tiyan ng ating ina at kumakalinga sa atin nang may pagkahabag. Pagkalooban nawa niya tayo ng kagalakan sa puso at paghariin ng kapayapaan sa Israel sa habang panahon. manatili nawa sa atin ang kanyang habag at laging iligtas tayo sa panahon ng kagipitan. The word of the Lord.
Señor, alaben el nombre del Señor. Bendito sea el nombre del Señor, ahora y por siempre. Bendito sea el nombre del Señor, por siempre. La salida del sol hasta su ocaso, alabado sea el nombre del Señor. El Señor se eleva sobre todos los pueblos, su gloria sobre el cielo. Bendito sea el nombre del Señor siempre. ¿Quién como el Señor Dios nuestro, que se eleva sobre su trono y se abaja para mirar al cielo y a la tierra? Bendito sea el nombre del Señor por siempre. Levanta del polvo al desvalido, alza de la basura al pobre, para sentarlo con los príncipes, los príncipes de su pueblo. Bendito sea el nombre del Señor por siempre.
Lectura de la primera carta del apóstol San Pablo a los Corintios. Hermanos, les deseamos la gracia y la paz de parte de Dios, nuestro Padre, y de Cristo Jesús, el Señor. Continuamente agradezco a mi Dios los dones divinos que les ha concedido a ustedes por medio de Cristo Jesús, ya que por él los ha enriquecido con abundancia en todo lo que se refiere a la palabra y al conocimiento. Porque el testimonio que damos de Cristo ha sido confirmado en ustedes a tal grado que no carecen de ningún don ustedes, los que esperan la manifestación de nuestro Señor Jesucristo. Él los hará permanecer irreprochables hasta el fin, hasta el día de su adviento. Dios es quien los ha llamado a la unión con su Hijo Jesucristo, y Dios es fiel. Palabra de Dios.
Aleluya, 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 aleluya. In all circumstances give thanks, for this is the will of God, for you in Christ Jesus. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. As Jesus continued his journey to Jerusalem, he traveled through Samaria and Galilee. As he was entering a village, 10 lepers met him. They stood at a distance from him and raised their voices, saying, "Jesus, Master, have pity on us." And when he saw them, he said, "Go show yourselves to the priests." As they were going, they were cleansed. And one of them, realizing he had been healed, returned, glorifying God in a loud voice. And he fell at the feet of Jesus and thanked him. He was a Samaritan. Jesus said in reply, 10 were cleansed, were they not? Where are the other 9? Has none but this foreigner returned to give thanks to God?" Then he said to him, "Stand up and go. Your faith has saved you." The Gospel of the Lord. So much is happening right now around the parish. There's food being prepared for 2,000, over 2,000 people there to be distributed.
Están preparando comida allá por más que 2,000 personas mientras estamos aquí. Muchas cosas pasando hoy.
En esta homilía voy a hablar un poco en inglés primero. Y después en español. ¿Ok? Muy bien. So, how do we move from trauma to thanksgiving? How do we move from trauma to thanksgiving? I think this is part of what the gospel shows us today. So, before I get into that, yesterday I watched a story about a young girl who is full of life and promise, who started waking up daily to serious migraines and discovered that she had lupus. By the time she was 19, due to her illness, she had cirrhosis of the liver and was facing either a transplant or death. Now, in a last-ditch move, her mother posted on Facebook, "My daughter needs a liver." Now, a young man who did not know them saw this Facebook post, and he felt like he had to try to help or he would not be able to live with himself. Long story short, they were a perfect match, which is kind of rare. And so this boy gave part of his liver to save this young woman. And so on live TV, they met. They were showing how they met for the first time
2 years after this surgery with their families. And there were tears of joy and gratitude streaming down their faces as they held each other in a beautiful embrace. Your trauma need not be a tragedy, but a ladder to deeper trust and to thanksgiving. Your trauma need not be a tragedy, but a ladder to deeper trust and to thanksgiving. For the 10 lepers in the gospel, and this may sound familiar, they were cut off because of their leprosy from gathering in community because they were considered unclean. They could not be physically touched. They had to maintain a physical distance from everyone. And that kind of rejection, abandonment can break you mentally and emotionally. It's kind of like a death sentence. But when all things had failed, they made a final push and ran into Jesus, who they had heard about. This man who said his mission was to liberate the captives, heal the blind and the lame, and proclaim a year of favor from the Lord. That year of favor meant restoration of all that was lost and being able to go back home. So listen, fellow trauma sufferers, we don't need to walk, but run to Jesus. Today, I think Jesus is saying, as he told the lepers, you are not powerless before your trauma. I'm sure that the lepers expected Jesus to come out and touch them and heal them, but he gave them instructions. You go and show yourself to the priest. Stop wandering in the mental fog and isolation and start walking towards the priest who represents the community and who can declare you clean. He's kind of saying, don't just wait for me, go, move. Like the mother who posted something on Facebook. Like the young man, that tug in his heart that was moving him to do something. Write that letter, make that call. And as you trust and move, you will be made whole. Your trauma will become your triumph. But don't forget the works of the Lord. You are here today. You are breathing. We are worshiping. We are serving and giving generously, as I said, feeding thousands of people. Many kids will have toys for Christmas. The food pantry will be restocked, all because of you. So maybe 2020 is more than the year of trauma. It is a year that calls us to trust Jesus and to live a life of gratitude. So get up, go, give generously, and you will know gratitude and you will find God. So just say with me, my trauma is my track towards trust. My trauma is my track towards trust. I will run to Jesus. I will run to Jesus. My trauma will be transformed into thanksgiving. My trauma will be transformed into thanksgiving in the name of Jesus. Okay, algunas palabras en español. 2020 ha sido un año desafiante. Uno de los grandes choques ocurrió en enero, aquí. Estaba parado afuera después de la misa saludando la gente y un joven se me acercó con lágrimas rodando por sus mejillas y dijo: Kobe Bryant acaba de morir en un accidente. ¿Recuerdas? Y pensé, ¿qué? Acabo de leer un tweet de él a LeBron James la noche anterior, después de que LeBron lo pasó en la lista de puntos en básquetbol. Simplemente increíble. Y si me dijeras que 2 meses después no podría quedarme afuera para saludar a nuestra familia del Blessed Sacrament, bendecir a las personas, hablar libremente con ellos, habría pensado que estabas loco. Pero eso es lo que estamos viviendo, el trauma de perder a seres queridos, el trauma de estar aislado, de no poder abrazar amigos, familiares, por algunos de perder un empleo de 10, 20, 30 años, de divorciarse, etcétera, etcétera. Y puede que tengas ganas de sacarte el pelo. Quizás piensas, ¿terminará esto alguna vez? Mira, escúchame. Tú, que están mirando aquí, que puedes tener pensamientos muy oscuros, como pensamientos suicidios. No te hagas daño. Probablemente se esté preguntando, ¿hay alguna manera de salir de este trauma y convertirse en acción de gracias? Pues la historia de los 10 leprosos nos dé una respuesta. El camino es Jesús. Hay las palabras de una canción que dicen, cuando necesito un amigo, corro hacia ti. Cuando parece el final, corro hacia ti. Bajo tus alas puedo volar. Estoy a salvo a tu lado. Corro hacia ti. Sé que hay aquellos para quienes este ha sido un tiempo de portafolios expandidos y están volando como un águila. Pues Dios los bendiga, ¿eh? Y espero que bendigan a sus familias y familia parroquial, porque somos como muchas familias que viven de cheque para cheque. Pero para muchos de nosotros, COVID nos ha cortado las alas y estamos buscando un salvavidas. No tema abrirle su trauma a Jesús. Te aseguro que si confías en Jesús, nunca te fallará. Hoy apoyémonos en Jesús. Hoy apoyémonos en reconectarnos con las fuentes de vida y amor que nos rodean. Hoy unámonos en el amor y el servicio a los que se sienten abandonados y marginados, como lo está haciendo el hermano Henry, que está andando ahora, y a todos ustedes que están aquí, que traigan generosamente hoy comida para los pobres y ayuda con nuestro árbol de dar. Puede decir conmigo, mi trauma es mi camino hacia la confianza. Correré a Jesús. Mi trauma se transformará en acción de gracias en el nombre de Jesús. Amén. Feliz día de acción de gracias. Happy Thanksgiving, everyone.
And so, my dear brothers and sisters, we turn our hearts and turn our prayers to our God. Mindful of God's blessings, we ask confidently for what we need.
For the church, for grateful hearts and generous hands, for repentant sinners and living saints, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Mapagaan nawa ng mga namumunong politiko ang mga mayroong mabigat na pasanin sa kabuhayan. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Por agua limpia y aire puro, para el buen uso de los productos naturales, roguemos al Señor.
Te rogamos. Óyenos.
For the members of this assembly, for their families and friends and neighbors, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Por nuestros enfermos o inválidos, Heriberto Villagrán, María Villeda, Jesús Ortega, Wagner Bowans, Alicia de Jesús, Rosa Sandoval, Roger Peter, Carlos Rubalcaba, David Moreno, y por los enfermos de COVID-19, roguemos al Señor.
Te rogamos, óyenos.
Por los recién fallecidos, José Olvera, por las intenciones en la caja de peticiones, roguemos al Señor.
Te rogamos, óyenos.
Let us pray in silence for our personal intentions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Dios de generosidad abundante, tú nos has colmado de cosas buenas. Tu Espíritu Santo nos ayuda a orar por todos los necesitados. Concédenos lo que te pedimos por Jesucristo, tu Hijo y Señor nuestro. Amén.
Amén.
Please remain standing. As we prepare to share God's gift, let us say the generosity prayer of Saint Ignatius. Lord, teach me to be generous. Teach me to serve you as you deserve, to give and not to count the cost, to fight and not to heed the wounds, to toil and not to seek for rest, to labor and not to ask for reward, save that of knowing that I do your will.
Por favor, permanezca de pie mientras nos preparamos para compartir los dones que Dios nos ha regalado. Recitemos la oración de la generosidad de San Ignacio de Loyola. Señor, enséñame a ser generoso, a servirte como tú lo mereces, a dar sin fijarme lo que cueste, a luchar sin preocuparme de las heridas, a esforzarme sin buscar descanso, a trabajar sin buscar recompensa, seguro de saber de que hago tu voluntad.
Please be seated. Siéntese, por favor. During this time, it's very memorable for our Mass and Thanksgiving when we bring up our non-perishable food donations for the food pantry. We will ask that that each row and perhaps the ushers might come forward and can help escort each row. So row by row, you will come up and you can put your envelope in the basket and or bring your food donations and place them on one of the carts, as you can see them over here where I'm pointing to the west side here. Okay. And thank you.
Favor de seguir las instrucciones de los ujieres. Van a pasar línea por línea con sus donaciones de comida o sus sobres. Los sobres los van a depositar en las canastas que están al frente y sus comidas en los carritos que están allá cerca de la baranda. Por favor, con orden. Muchas gracias.
Señor, nos da su amor como nadie nos lo da.
Señor nos da su amor como nadie nos lo dio, y su amor tan grande fue que lo condujo hasta la cruz, pero más pudo el amor que la muerte y el dolor. Él cerró tres días después, resucitó. Es mi cuerpo, toma y comer, es mi sangre, toma.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, que este sacrificio aquí en Atiño sea agradable a Dios, the Father Almighty.
Que el Señor reciba de tus manos este sacrificio para alabanza y gloria de su nombre, para el de nuestro bien y de toda su santa iglesia.
Señor, tú que nos diste a tu Hijo para que nos librará de la muerte y de todo mal, acepta este sacrificio que te ofrecemos en acción de gracias por habernos librado de nuestras tribulaciones through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Creator of the world and source of life. For you never forsake the works of your wisdom, but by your providence are even now at work in our midst with mighty hand and outstretched arm. You led your people through Israel through the desert. Hoy acompañas a tu iglesia peregrina dándole la fuerza de tu espíritu. Por medio de tu Hijo nos abres el camino de la vida para que a través de este mundo lleguemos al gozo perfecto de tu reino. Por eso con los ángeles y los santos we too sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Oh,
and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son present in our midst when we are gathered by his love. And when as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you."
Señor mío y Dios mío,
del mismo modo, tomó el cáliz lleno de vino, te dio gracias con la plegaria de bendición, y lo pasó a sus discípulos diciendo: "Tomen y beban todos de él, porque este es el cáliz de mi sangre, sangre de la alianza nueva y eterna que será derramada por ustedes y por muchos para el perdón de los pecados. Hagan esto en conmemoración mía."
Señor mío y Dios mío.
The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion.
Fortalécenos con este mismo espíritu a todos los que hemos sido invitados a tu mesa, para que todos nosotros, pueblo de Dios, con nuestros pastores, el Papa Francisco, nuestro obispo José, con los presbíteros y los diáconos, caminemos alegres en la esperanza y firmes en la fe, y comuniquemos al mundo el gozo del Evangelio. Subió en tu auxilio en ofrecer, que si son endormidos en la esperanza de la resurrección, et tu l'homme qui ont quitté cette vie, reçoile dans la lumière auprès de toi. Tinipon mo kami rito sa hapag nang iyong anak, kaisa nang mahal na Bireng Maria, ina nang Dios, sampu nang mga banal, sa bagong San Sinukob na magatangkal, sa kaganapan nang iyong kapayapaan, tipunin mo an lahat ng lahi, wika at kalinangan, upang makibahagi sa salu-salong walang hagan, kasama ni Jesucristong aming Panginoon.
through him and with him and in him. O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Pues ahora, como hijos de Dios, as beloved children of God, let us pray in our own language with confidence the words that our Savior gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that in your mercy we may be free from sin and protected from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, Señor Jesucristo, que dijiste a tus apóstoles, la paz les dejo, mi paz les doy. No tengas en cuenta nuestros pecados, sino la fe de tu iglesia. Y conforme a tu palabra, concédele la paz y la unidad, tú que vives y reinas por los siglos de los siglos.
Amén.
La paz del Señor, the peace of the Lord, be with you always. Pues ahora, con distancia física, la paz de Cristo a todos. La paz de Cristo. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. How blessed are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the words, and my soul shall be healed.
Pueden sentarse por un momento. You know, Scripture tells us in Hebrews that Jesus, our Lord, is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Nuestro Señor Jesús es lo mismo ayer, hoy, y para siempre. In the same way that His Word and His instruction and His presence brought healing and life, He is here to do the same for us. Y este día de acción de gracias, y damos gracias por la presencia de Jesús, nuestro Redentor, Salvador, nuestra sanación, vida que está aquí. Ahora, por los que no están presentes y no pueden, vamos a hacer una comunión espiritual. We'll make a spiritual communion now. Creo, Jesús mío, que estás presente en el Santísimo Sacramento del altar. Te amo sobre todas las cosas y deseo recibirte en mi alma. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though you have already come, I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. No permitas que jamás me aparte de ti. Thank you.
And let us pray. O God, who have given us as spiritual food the saving sacrament of your Son, which we have offered you in thanksgiving, grant that being strengthened by gifts of courage and joy, we may serve you more devotedly and be worthy of still further blessings. Por Cristo nuestro Señor. Amén.
Okay. Puedes sentar, tenemos anuncios.
We have some announcements. Okay.
Tenemos unos anuncios. Actually, we just have a couple. After I express thanksgiving, of course, to all of our liturgies, and especially our music ministry and our production ministry, our wonderful cantors, both Tom and Edgar, and our wellness ministry, and Maria Dominguez, who is just such a humble servant for all of the work she does for our environmental ministry, and Oscar Torres as well. So thank you so very much. And for todos los ministros. Todos, todos. Okay. The rectory office is closed today and tomorrow. We will reopen on Saturday. La oficina de la rectoría está cerrada hoy y mañana. Va a abrir en sábado. We do have a special announcement regarding the Christmas giving tree. It is now placed near the grotto in front of the rectory office. So after Mass, please go and pick an ornament off the tree that has a child's age and gender for a Christmas gift, and make sure you sign up with your name and contact information. Be careful and stand on the designated lines to be physically distanced. Thank you to Jorge Garcia and our Knights and Yolanda Lichman for decorating the tree with these ornaments.
El arbolito de Navidad para los niños está cerca de la Gruta de la Virgen de Guadalupe, enfrente de la oficina. La rectoría, después de la misa, a favor, vayan y tomen un ornamento del arbolito, cual tiene la edad y el género de niña o niña. Fírmelo con su nombre y su número de teléfono. Tenga cuidado de guardar la distancia en la línea designada. Le damos las gracias a Jorge García y los Caballeros de Colán por decorar y poner el arbolito con sus ornamentos. Gracias.
Is Brother Henry here? Brother Henry, oh, here we are. Please step forward. Brother Henry is the leader for all of these essential services involving feeding, and he is a professional chef. So I'd like for him to speak just a little bit about Genevieve's garden. You can see that he has on his shirt, Gobble, Gobble, Give. Brother Henry.
Hi, you guys. Happy Thanksgiving. My name is Brother Henry. Mi nombre es Hermano Quique. Feliz de Acción de Gracias, ¿sí? Hey. Today, I wanted to tell you a little bit about what we're doing here at Genevieve's Garden at Blessed Sacrament. We have an organization called Gobble, Gobble, Give that is preparing 2,000 meals that will be spread out throughout the city to people that are hungry, that need help, that are poor. So a big shout out to Gobble, Gobble, Give. That's right here on Blessed Sacrament. Woo! The Hollywood Food Coalition that does so much good in gathering food that would go to a landfill. We have three sites. Blessed Sacrament is one of three sites that will be handing out grab-and-go meals off of Castle right here, and that will start after the Mass. So a big shout out to the Hollywood Food Coalition and to Blessed Sacrament for handing out 500 meals. And then today at Genevieve's Garden, after Mass, we're going to be seating two people per table to have a sit-down meal to relax a little bit and eat a Thanksgiving meal. And then Yolanda and Blessed Sacrament has been kind enough to allow us to set up tables here where we're having Mass to assist anybody else that is coming in that wants to sit down for a few minutes and eat a Thanksgiving meal. So a big shout out to Blessed Sacrament and Genevieve's Garden. I want to thank all the volunteers that made it possible and all of you that have donated time, money, making turkeys and pies. Thank you all. We couldn't make this happen without all of you. So thank you so much. God bless you and happy Thanksgiving.
You see, it's Thanksgiving here every day. So our equipo, nuestro equipo pastoral, and our students and our families, we wish you a blessed and happy Thanksgiving. Feliz Día de Acción de Gracias. Maligayang pasalamat sa inyong lahat. Thank you.
Amen. We now pray for a blessing. Just a little final word. We talked about trauma, trust, leading into Thanksgiving. So if you feel like you're in a place of trauma, lean into trusting God. If you feel like you're in a place where you're trusting and walking without seeing the results yet, lean into Thanksgiving. Start giving thanks like you've received it already. And if you're in a place of thanksgiving, don't forget the time of trauma and other people who are suffering traumas, like you all are remembering and helping them today. Let me try to say it in español. Si siente que está experimentando un trauma, apóyese en la confianza. Si siente que está caminando confiado sin ver, apóyese en la acción de gracias, como te has recibido ya. Y si te sientes lleno de gratitud, no olvides a los que están sufriendo traumas, como todos ustedes lo están haciendo hoy a través de su inmensa generosidad. Gracias a todos ustedes y gracias a Dios. Amén.
Amén.
Inclinen, bow your heads for the final blessing. May the God of all consolation order your days in his peace and grant you the gifts of his blessing. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
May he turn your steps toward himself and pour out saving wisdom upon you. And let the church say amen. Amen. Que Dios omnipotente aleje de ustedes toda adversidad y les conceda la abundancia de sus bendiciones. Y amen. La iglesia dice, amén.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you. Angama atanganak atang Espíritu Santo. Amén. Pues, our Mass has ended. La liturgia está terminado. Pues, podemos ir en la paz y en gratitud.
Demos gracias al Señor.
Like
Amen.